Okay, as you start your animals project, there's going to be a little bit more information you're going to need to know other than some of the stuff we learned in the videos. So the first thing we're going to is the phylums and the classes. So as we look at how organisms were classified, we know that they are classified according to kingdom, phylum, class, kingdom, game, order, family, genus, and then species. So as we look at this, we know that all animals are in the kingdom Animalia. We know that there are two major phylums. You have invertebrates and vertebrates. And then the classes and orders get a little bit of goofy, and so do actually the phylums. But we're going to look at the major categories of organisms. And you're going to, the phylums basically are going to be grouped according to how your book has them grouped, and that's how we're going to go through them. And so as you look at it, invertebrates are divided into the following phylums, and you have Porifera, Cnidarian, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, Annelida, Mollusca, Arthropoda, and Echinodermata. Porifera basically are sponges. Cnidarians are going to be jellyfish. Platyhelminthes are going to be flatworms or planaria. Nematodes are going to be roundworms. Those are what you saw in the water samples. Annelids are going to be segmented worms like earthworms. Mollusca are going to be things like clams. Arthropoda are going to be things. They actually have two major categories. We're going to subdivide. One are insects and the other one are crustaceans. You also have Echinodermata, which are sea stars. And then you have vertebrates, and we're going to do the following vertebrates that you see down below. They're labeled as chordata because they have that spinal cord. So you're going to look at reptilians, amphibians, or mammalian. So you'll choose one of these major categories. And then you're going to look at in depth into that category. And if you look at the rubric that I gave you for, or the outline I gave you for your animals project, so I say go in depth into classes, but I also say exactly what are the differences in the classes. So for each of these, you might have three different types of sponges. You might have three different types of jellyfish, three different types of flatworms. I want you to have basically kind of pictures or examples of those and then describe their differences. So that's what I'm asking for when you look at what are the phylums, what are the characteristics of the phyla. So the characteristics of the phyla might be that they are segmented or they have an internal shell. So each of these are going to have specific characteristics by which they define them, and then you're going to have to go in and find the different classes and what are the differences of those classes. You're going to take a look at is the body plans and adaptation. So many of them are organized according to their symmetry. And what we mean by symmetry basically is how can it be divided. So it's the balance and properties of an object or organism. There's three different types: asymmetry, radial symmetry, or bilateral symmetry. So as we look at asymmetry, most of you know that if you look at the term A, that means without. Radial is going to mean on a radius, and bilateral is going to be mean that it can be divided into two parts. So as we take a look at this, an organism with asymmetry might be something like a sponge. And a sponge I can take and I can divide any of these parts, and they're going to have the same characteristics. Radial symmetry you have to think of kind of like a pizza. So if I were to divide the slices in a pizza, I could divide them, and each of these parts are going to be the same. Bilateral symmetry basically just means that it's going to have two similar right and left halves. So if this were a human, you would have arms that come out here and legs, and we know I'm a complete artist. My symmetry is a little off there, but that's okay. So these would have equal right and left halves. The unique thing about this is, so bilateral symmetry organisms are only going to have basically a top and a bottom. So they're only going to have an anterior and a posterior surface. As you look at bilateral symmetry, then we have not only anterior and posterior, which is going to mean anterior means near the head, and posterior means near tail. Okay? And so as you have those two components, we also have right and left halves, or top and bottom halves, and those are known as dorsal and ventral. Okay, so dorsal is going to be like the dorsal fin on a fish. Ventral is always going to be like the belly surface. So you have the back surface and the belly surface. And you do need to go through and describe those on your actual organism that you'll be using for your dissection.